substantial new downstructure, hence the development that you mentioned in my report. Well, thanks very much for the question.
Thank you, Councillor Jones. Councillor Steve Barton.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. My question is to Liz Gray, Member for Environment and Climate Change. It's perhaps a couple of parts. Can you update us on any progress made to improve recycling on Wirral? And there's mention in your report about the pollinators plan, and can you update us on the progress on that matter, please?
And for this.
The first question is about recycling. Yeah, I've got some information about recycling. We launched a recycle right campaign in January 19th and January this year. And since then, it's been very successful. Our recycling rates have been much higher each month than the same time last year. We're still off our target, but we're heading in the right direction. And this is the first time in 5 years that we've been reversing the trend, which is a national trend for recycling rates to go down. Our recycling rates are actually improving. We're working with Community Action Wirral and Wirral Environmental Network to compile a comprehensive list of environmental and volunteer groups, reuse opportunities in Wirral, and to point people to these when they ask for recycling opportunities. We're promoting reuse, and we'll be issuing information about that soon, and the love where you live one will be issued soon.
Pollinators plan, you mentioned that.
Yes, the pollinators plan.
Okay. One more question. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's fine. That's it.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. A question to the Cabinet Member for the local plan. Councillor Lisa Leach will have heard from earlier on this evening that a petition of 268 names has been submitted from residents of Lisa Moore Police Board asking for protection for the Ditton Lane Nature Reserve. Can the Cabinet Member please advise Council whether this particularly important local ecological site will be included in her deliberations on the local plan?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I have been approached by a number of residents in respect of this aspect, and I've been doing some research to see whether any of the trees could actually be TPO'd before any applications come forward. Additionally, within the local plan, we will be taking into consideration a number of areas, not just Ditton Lane. But Ditton Lane is currently not classed as an official nature reserve. There are other nature reserves within the area which are obviously classed as official, but this one isn't currently. But we will be taking residents' views into consideration.
Okay, thank you. Right, can I have Councillor Carlton back?
This is a question for the Member for Environment and Climate Change. Does she believe her response to the incident at Hilby Island has put the authority of the government and just weeks on declaring a climate emergency? Thank you.
Councillor Gray. Okay, Councillor Stewart.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
sites are reported as not working. And we are dealing with them on an ad hoc basis as we're having those reports. There are some councillors who've written to me separately, and I have picked those up. And with the exception of perhaps one or two occasions, I believe now that those lights are working. But what I would say to you is that if you find that's not the case, then please come back to me straight away. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Councillor Sam Frost.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Really important to the topic. I've got a question for the Cabinet for Environment and Climate Change. Can you give us an update on where the March 2019 without a valid or dummy purchase order number.
And can the Cabinet Member confirm how many invoices from April 2019 to date have been paid out by the purchase order number? And can she give reassurance to the members here that the new policy is in effect?
Thank you.
If I have two other questions. I'm sure you can say that I actually haven't got through to Mr. Hammond. I was struggling to keep up because you asked me quite fast. Could you just clarify what numbers you needed there in an email and get the information to you as soon as possible? Or just hand it over.
Cheers. Okay, thank you. Councillor Joel Walsh.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. My question is obviously being called.
Okay, thank you. Councillor Tony Norbury.
Okay, Mr. Mayor, my question also has been covered, which is.
Right. Councillor Steve.
Yeah. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. My question is to Cabinet Member for Anderson, Ken Belding, Councillor Chris Jones. In your report, you say Wirral Council has seen the smoking population dropping by more than a third, well below the Northwestern national average. Also, the state of the carbon is ABL, way above the national and regional average to support the smokers who successfully quit at the and that last year the service supported more than 3,000 residents to ditch their cigarettes. My question is, does this figure mean that there are more than 3,000 smokers of cigarettes, which also include electronic delivery system substitute smokers who have ditched this habit? Or to phrase it another way, does this figure include those who have switched from normal cigarettes to electronic smoking methods as well?
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Police are sold of cigarettes. I think we all know that vaping is the new way really that a lot of smokers try to stop smoking traditional cigarettes. But ABL are working hard with lots of efforts, including limiting replacement therapies. But I think vaping is something that we're all really concerned about, especially when younger people are starting to use vapes rather than smoking traditional cigarettes. And we'll be doing everything we can to continue the trend of helping people to stop.
Thank you, Councillor John. Councillor Leslie Rennie.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. So my question is to Councillor Julie McManus for Community Services. It's in relation to LED lights, which is slightly different from the question that's already been asked. At the last council meeting, Councillor Rennie, which I couldn't attend, but I have to say I did watch it on the live webcast. That's how sad my life has become. I think you did promise there to publish the programme for the LED streetlights to enable members and also residents to see when roads would benefit from the programme. I'm delighted that the programme has actually started, but can you confirm if the details have actually been published? And just as part of that question as well, I was wondering whether or not you're in a position to inform the council tonight about the number of streetlights street lighting columns which are unlit this week. And finally, as well, as part of the one question, also could you please take note that when a lighting column has been replaced, that the L lighting columns are removed immediately?
I think that's three questions.
Spaces in Wirral.
one of the few remaining examples of lowland heating in the northwest of England, recognised by Natural England as an SSSR in special status protection. However, the Dales continues to suffer from lack of ranger power, manpower, and lack of access to equipment needed for its maintenance. This threatens its SSSR status. There has been no ranger cover since May, despite both suitable qualified staff and equipment being available elsewhere in Wirral. Will the Cabinet Member assure Wirral Council honour its commitments to preserve the Heswell Dales and its special status into the future by providing adequate and suitable skilled resources, making available the equipment needed, working across its own administrative boundaries as needed? Over 200 volunteers are desperately trying to help this council and not really given the support they deserve.
Thank you, Councillor Gordon. Councillor Judith Powers.
Thank you for your question, Councillor Owen. I do believe that there's an extra member to have that's been recruited. I can't answer you as to why there's been a lack of ranger support, but I can assure you that there will be moving forward. Thank you.
Thank you. Councillor Andrew Hodgson.
This is for question of the Cabinet Member for Housing and Planning. Can the Cabinet Member advise how this has been received from the Ministry for Housing and Local Government for disabled facilities grants in the last two financial years? And for the last year, if all the money received, committed or spent by the year end?
Councillor Biddy.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. That's a question. I do believe that's not many people's.
Thank you.
will not be done in one total borough-wide consultation, but rather as individuals, so that we can look at individual areas and address what needs local residents want, so that we may well be able to offer different things at libraries, certainly more of a central hub. And I believe that I can agree that the capital spend is, yeah, thank you.
Okay, thank you. Right, I need people to stand up again. We're talking about the question, I'm getting about that. Councillor Steve Williams and then Councillor Michael Collins. We have time, okay?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. A question for the Chair of the Environment Overview and Scrutiny Committee, Councillor Collins. Can the Chair of the Environment Committee give a commitment to work with the Boroughs, Allotment Society and the Council that will lead to an increase in the land available for allotments with a reduction in the waiting list for plots? If you can bear in mind wards such as mine, North Western Silver Massive, presently have no allotments at all. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Thanks for that.
Thank you, Steve, for your question. I do agree that there's been a distinct lack of engagement with our allotment societies and a lack of provision where it doesn't meet the Wirral 2020 budget and we're going back down. So consequently, we, through a number of colleagues, have raised this issue with me.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The question is to the Cabinet Member for Children's Services, Councillor Tomlinson. Has Cabinet Member been given an indication by Merseyside Police as to how many of the 200 new police officers being recruited in Phase 1 will be based within Wirral?
Spend under review. Unfortunately, we're still waiting for central government to sort of two votes in the goal mess that is Brexit. So we would like to know as much as you'd like to know too. And the uncertainty is not very good for any of us. As soon as I know, I'll let you know.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor Jake Cannon.
Thank you. My question is for Joe Williamson. Thank you for your report. And just to ask you, could you update us on what's happening with the Community Bank after we did a really positive report in the Rural Globe? Thank you. My question is, so the situation is that I'm about to go to Preston this week for a further meeting. We've incorporated the North West Mutual and are in the process of a private banking licence. We're very hopeful that from next year we will have our first branch open and it will form a central plank of our community wealth building strategy, which is absolutely desperately needed in this borough. Okay, thank you.